Alright, today I'll be talking about vector space. Now, what is vector space? In vector space, we define a field as constants like lambda, beta, alpha, and whatever symbols you can think of, and vectors are represented with letters. So now, I want to show in this particular series how that when is a set said to be a vector space. Now, he said a non-empty set of elements called vector with two operations, addition and multiplication, is called a vector space if and only if it satisfies the following axioms. That is, I can only say a vector is a vector space over a field if it satisfies these rules. Now, I want us to be very attentive here. The first rule is additive closure. That is, for every U and V in V, whenever I see this sign, it means for every, or you say for all. Have you got what I'm saying now? So that is what that sign means. So this means for all U and V in. So this sign from our knowledge on set means membership. This sign denotes membership. So this means for every U and V in a vector, then U plus V should also be in the what? In the vector. Then the next one is scalar closure. This one says for every alpha in field F, for every alpha in field F and U in what? In V, which is vector, then alpha U should also be in the what? In the vector. I get what I'm saying now. So that's the second law, scalar closure. Then the third one is commutativity. That is, the set must be commutative. Then this means for every U and V in V, then U V plus U should also be in what? In V. Are you getting what I'm saying now? Now, the next one says this commutative law is a very simple one. That is, your V plus U should be equal to your U plus V. That is, if you have 1 plus 1, it should be the same thing. I mean, if you have 2 plus 1, it should give you the same thing as 1 plus what? 2. So that is what commutativity is saying there. Then the additive associativity. This one says that for every U, V, W in vector, then U plus open bracket V plus W should give you the same thing as U plus V plus W. I got what I'm saying. Now, this additive associativity and commutativity are almost the same thing. I got what I'm saying. But this additive associativity means it is not dealing with three vectors. I get what I'm saying now, so that is what it means. Then this one, zero vectors, this means this sign that you are seeing means, so whenever I see sign like this, it means if there exists, so that's what the sign means. If there exists zero in V, now this particular sign means such that. These are signs that you must know as you go on in this course, such that U plus zero is equal to U for every U in what? In V. So I repeat again, if there exists zero in V, such that U plus what? Zero is equal to what? U for every U in what? In V. Then the additive inverse now says, for every U in V, there exists minus U in V, such that U plus open bracket minus U should give you zero. Now, all these laws, you might be thinking they are not so important. All these laws we are seeing here, we are going to be applying it, and this is what we are going to be using to tell us that a vector is fulfilling a vector space axioms. Are you getting what I'm saying here now? Now, the next one is scalar multiplication associativity. when you hear the word associativity, it means it is dealing with two or more variables. Are you getting what I'm saying now? So this one says, for every alpha and beta in field. Don't forget that I said alpha, beta, and any other sign are constant and they are under field. And U in V. So I repeat again, for every alpha and beta in F and U in V, comma, alpha open bracket B U close bracket should give you alpha beta open close bracket or U. That is when you multiply alpha with beta and U, it should be the same thing you get when you multiply alpha beta with U. I get what I'm saying now, Ned. So I'll be using some of these rules in the example, and you should also note that anytime you are dealing with vector space, immediately these first two laws are fulfilled. If these first two laws are fulfilled, then it is certain that these other ones will be fulfilled. So in this particular one, again, distributive across vector addition. He said it must be distributive across vector addition. That is, if there exists alpha in F and UV in V, comma, alpha open bracket U plus V should give me the same thing as alpha U plus alpha V. I get what I'm saying now. Alpha open bracket U plus V should give me the same thing as what alpha U plus what alpha V. That is, opening the brackets with the alpha. Alpha multiplied by U should give you alpha U. Alpha multiplied by V should give you alpha V. Then distributive across scalar addition. It should be distributive across scalar addition also. That is, for every alpha beta in F and U in V, then alpha plus beta multiplied by U should give you what? U alpha plus what? U beta. So this particular two are also most likely to be the same thing. So here that is dealing with vector, you know that you have two vector. Here that is dealing with scalar, you have two scalar. Then the last rule here is the existence of one. Existence of one. That means for every U in V, then one multiplied by U should also give you what? U. Have you get what I'm saying now? So these are some of the rules you must know as you go on in this particular course. Now let's see an example. He said, if V is minus 1, 0, and 1, show that V is a vector space. Now, how am I going to show this? It is very simple. The first law, additive closure, states that for every UV in V, U plus V should also be what? In V. This is my U, this is my V, this is my W. Have you got what I'm saying now? So U plus V minus 1 plus 0 will give you what? Minus 1. And you can see that your minus 1 is also in what? In your vector V. Do we get that now? So this is what it means by additive closure. So minus 1 is in V. That is what the law is trying to explain there. Do we get that? Then scalar closure. It says that for every alpha in F and U in V, alpha U should also be in what? In V. Now in this case you might be thinking, alpha U, I don't have alpha in my V now. Now from here, if you multiply alpha with your minus 1, it will give you minus alpha, right? And if you multiply the same thing here, it will give you what? Minus alpha. Alpha will cancel alpha, and we have what? Your minus 1 back. Don't forget I said, if these two laws are fulfilled, then it is certain that every other 8 axioms will be fulfilled. Then this other one, commutativity. It says that my V plus U should give me what? U plus what? V. So let's try that. That will be minus 1 plus what? 0. And it should be the same thing as what? 0 plus minus 1, right? So let me put this in brackets to avoid confusion there. And that will be minus 1 equals what? Minus 1. And you can see that your minus 1 is in what? Is in V. Did we get that now? So let's run through this last one. And you can try for the other 6. Now this one, additive associativity, state that for every UV and W in V, then U plus V, U plus open bracket V plus W close bracket should give me the same thing as what? U plus V plus W. So let's try that. What's my U here? That's minus 1, right? Plus open bracket what? 0 plus 1, right? It should give me the same thing as what?
minus 1 plus 0, open bracket 1. So let's see, that would be minus 1 plus 1, right? Equals to minus 1. Minus 1, this is plus 1 here. Then minus 1 plus what? 1. And this will be what? 0. Equals what? 0. And you can see that it is the same thing with the rule we have. And you can also see that your 0 is in what? Is in V. So these are the rules you have to know under this. You can go ahead and try for the other 6. You can try for 0 vectors and other vectors. So don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification button. Thank you very much.